probably my most difficult filming location I've ever had to get to, the stairs from Dirty Dancing, which are inaccessible to anyone, I am now at them. And now, I'm going to show you.
Go on without me. Tell the world my story.
I know you gonna dig this.
Get funky with me.
What's going on, everybody? How you doing today? So here I am in Pembroke, Virginia, and it is frosty outside. It's chilly. It's dirty. It's not dirty at all. It's very clean. This movie, though, I remember when I was a kid watching it and liking it, but I hadn't seen it really since. I'd seen the ending scene about 1,000 times because I love that ending scene. You know what I'm talking about.
Daddy, watch me twirl.
So when I was thinking about doing the locations for Dirty Dancing, I watched it again just last night. I loved it. But I always thought that it was dirt. Like, I forgot the plot. I thought that they were in trouble for Dirty Dancing. I thought that's what the whole thing. I wasn't smart as a kid either, so probably didn't understand anything. But am I smart as an adult? No. But it's not about that at all. You know what Dirty Dancing is about. Everybody knows Dirty Dancing, right? Patrick Swayze falls in love with a department store mannequin. Then he makes like a clay vase with a little boy. And finally he lifts Ferris Bueller's sister up into the sky. It's a wonderful film.
Johnny Castle, baby. They fall in love at a resort. Father doesn't want them together. I thought that was more the plot. That doesn't really happen to the end. It's a great movie. It's Dirty Dancing. I'm at the locations for it. I love this movie. Here it is. They've got it all mapped out here too. Shot at two different resorts. One in Virginia, one in North Carolina. I'm going to both. But here, this is the main one. Mountain Lodge. Right on the screen. All right. Dirty Dancing locations. Let's do this. Finally, I'm here.
Hey, baby.
So we're gonna go inside in a moment. I'm gonna show you the Harvest Restaurant. That's where all the restaurant scenes are filmed. But of course, they arrive. And they arrive right here. And the camera comes down just about like this. That's the restaurant up there. And it was open. It was an open area. And now they've enclosed it. Because as you see, it gets cold out here. But they pulled up right here. And Newman greets them. How awesome is that? This place is impressive. It's all made of stone, even the beds. It's really, really cool. And this is the restaurant from the movie right here. And I'll go in and show you all the scenes that took place inside. So what I can tell by this, just by the rocks in the background, which is really cool, is the table would have been off to this side right here. And this lamp is the same lamp in the scene. And these rocks are the same rocks. Very, very unmistakable. So right there is where they were standing, having that meeting. Now, this used to be an open patio, but it is now enclosed because of the weather. But these white shutters, these were installed for the movie. These ones here. And they're still here. So that's the restaurant inside. Now we're going to walk down. Fun facts. Like, look at this. They've got it all set up all over the place. The white bollards and chains that line the front lawn. Yeah. The beach area, now a playground. Right there. Oh, that's baby's cabin. Spray painting all the trees and green grass because it was fall. They filmed in the fall. And adding the awnings over the porch windows in harvest. Shh, back there, lady. Shh. You can come here and just walk around. They're really into it. Oh, there's more. Okay, so I'm gonna explain something else in a second, but I'm gonna mansplain it. Scottsplain it. Really annoying, but something about this. So here's where all the games were taking place. You can see the gazebo in the background. It's really cool. Right here. This is where all the, and when they were doing these, the front lawn, all the games playing here, it was getting even deeper into like the fall, and they had to use food coloring on the grass and the plants and stuff. So they weren't just using spray paint. Food coloring. Food.
Oh, look at all this leftover food.
I should add, while I'm walking through this mud, that it's one of the best-selling soundtracks of all time. I consider it a musical. My friend yelled at me the other day saying it's not a musical. I mean, I get it. They're not singing, but it's set to music and dancing. So it's kind of a musical, but it's not. It's got one of my favorite songs of all time, Be My Baby by the Ronettes. Rest in peace, Ronnie Spector. I love that song. And that woman, what a tremendous artist. And here's the gazebo. Look at it. There it is, right there. The gazebo. Come on. I just have to aim my camera and it's so easy. Oh, something good's coming up. Something good is coming up. But let's look at the gazebo. Now, apparently it says 1986 and they covered it up because the movie takes place in 63, right? But there's an engraving somewhere where it says 1986. New floor, I'm assuming. Oh yeah, 1986, Mountain Lake, there you go. So they covered that up in the movie. Uh-oh, you know what happened out there. This is awesome. Yo, B-Pats, my friend Brad, he loves this movie. What up, dog? What? How you doing, man? He loves this movie, so everybody loves this movie. Right there, that's the gazebo. All those dance lessons, everything right here. Now, should I go left or right? We'll go left because I want to go to the thing on the right. That's a big thing that I want to show you. Let's go over to Baby's Cabin. Baby's Cabin. And here we go. They give you a little map too. I've got a map and all these signs. Baby's Cabin, the Virginia Cottage. And you can rent it and stay it, and it sleeps up to 10. Right there. Wow. Now this playground was not here. This is going to mess up my shot. So I'm going to get an axe from my car and tear it down quickly. And then put it back together because I'm very handy. Of course she comes running out. She wants to go check out what's going on at the hotel. She's a busybody. Ferris Bueller's sister. And she runs right up there. And that's the restaurant. That's where she spots Johnny Castle. Or as I like to call him. Prefer to call him. Derry Curtis. Played by the incomparable and greatly missed Patrick Swayze. What? Swayze. What does this sign say? I'm just gonna walk down here and see what this sign says. I'm curious. Now the lake is gone, as you can see. And, oh God. It's still mucky, but it's freezing cold. Like I'm kind of shivering, so the camera's moving. I'm not using my gimbal either. Jimmy Gimbal. But notice, keep out of pond. No swimming, no fishing, no boating. No chance. There's no water. There's a little bit there. Mom, can we go in the lake? Sure. Just stick to the shore.
We take the paddle boats out? Sure, just, you know, be prepared to dig. That's stupid.
So apparently the lake came back in 2020. Like, it's completely, oh, look, gazebo. It came back. Oh, what's this over here? Oh, this is cool. Because the lake's dried up, but it came back in 2020, and now it's gone again. I don't know how that works. Nature, stupid. Oh, this is nice. This stone is in memory of Patrick Swayze, 1952 to 2009, for a starring role in the hit movie of 1987, Dirty Dancing, and to his courageous battle with pancreatic cancer. Dedicated November 21st, 2009. Wow. Now, there's a lot of discrepancy because Lake Lure out in North Carolina claims that the lift scene took place out there. That's where the stairs are, where she dances up the stairs, and a few other scenes like the staff quarters and all that. It was all filmed there. We're going there. It's going to take me a week to get all this stuff filmed, but they claim that the lift scene was filmed there. It was not. Not throwing no shade on Lake Lure, but it was filmed here on the east side of the lake. The cinder blocks used for the platform that Johnny stood on during this scene are still there. And the reason there are no close-ups of this shot is because baby's lips were blue. Just like the tips of my fingers. So we're going to go down and see the actual cinder blocks that Patrick Swayze stood on. What? That's wild. Baby's lips were blue. Everything on me is blue, not including my jacket. Look how far away I am from the mountain lodge. I'm in the middle of where the lake was. I'm standing in the Dirty Dancing Lake. Look at the ground. It's marshy. It's gross. I'm wearing white shoes after Labor Day. But I found it. I found exactly where the lift scene was. She told me they were covered in moss, and they're covered in moss. Those are the cinder blocks that Patrick Swayze stood on for them to practice the lift. And you can tell, I mean, how the other lake tries to get away with saying that it was filmed there, it completely matches up with the background. Like, that's, you know, those sets of trees, then those ones back there. It's a match right there. Oh, am I having the time of my life? I'm really digging this. Sometimes I get burnt out on filming locations, and I've been doing it for so long. But then something like this comes along, cinder blocks right there. So this is where it was, and I don't know what that would think. So I'm really enjoying this. Oh, that's cold. Look, I don't know what that is. Cinder blocks right here. Patrick Swayze stood here. Ferris Bueller's sister, Jennifer Grey, the beautiful, beautiful Jennifer Grey, jumped here. I don't see why they just don't fill it back. Get a garden hose, run it down, start filling it up, get it ready for the spring. I don't understand science. I'm sure that would work. Blueberries. Yeah, so let's do a little turnaround here. Some guy wrote on one of my videos recently, "You digress too much." I'm not digressing right now, and that guy needs to shut up. It was right here. This is the lake. Baby's cabin. Mountain lodge. Gazebo. Going back up here. Not digressing. I wonder what kind of vegetation this is. Are bears in Virginia? I'm pretty sure bears are in Virginia, but they're hibernating. They're tired. You digress too much. You talk too much, buddy. Whatever the hell you were. I love my viewers, but this one dude, you digress too much. What do you do? What are you? Some sort of medieval torture device. There's more of you. Oh, this is like a boat. This is a boat launch. Is it? I don't know. Pretty cool. Take the boat out for a nice drag. So I should say that it was filmed in, they began filming in September of 1986, and this lodge was chosen at the last minute.
But the cast and crew actually stayed here while they were guests. So Patrick Swayze, Jennifer Grey, Newman, Jerry Orbach, Cynthia Rhodes, they stayed here in the main cabin, in the main lodge. Baby's cabin, gazebo. Okay, a couple more things I'm gonna show you. And then we're going to North Carolina. Whew! And if I'm breathing heavy during this video, it's not because the dirty dancing has got me all worked up. It's because I've been walking around in the freezing cold. Okay, that's too much. Now, pay very close attention to what this sign says. Do not enter wrong way. Let's go this way. We're a person. We're not a car. We can walk. But a car should not be driving this way. But Johnny Castle does. Because his car, he smashes the window because they got to get out of there. And it goes from like night to day. It's a little weird. It looks dark at first. Like it looks light outside when they're dancing inside. Then it looks dark. Then it's light. But it's a storm. It drives right through there. Right that away. So a lot of scenes take place up here. This is pre-Watermelon. If you look to your left, you'll see the staff quarters sign. Okay. Looks like it's gone. It's gone. And Baby sees this sign before she encounters Johnny's cousin. And with the watermelons, is all spot Baby and Johnny hiding from her dad. So Baby and Johnny are walking right up here. It's a very tight shot, and there's two little poles on each side of them. And they're walking right up here. And they hide from her dad. Her dad, his dad. From Jerry Orbach. North Carolina. What are these? Propane? Submarines? Milk? I don't know. Not a science guy. All right, I'm gonna fall. I'm gonna walk really slowly like I poop my pants. Like, you know, like you spread your... When you were a kid, if you pooped your pants. Well, maybe you still do. I feel like I want to. You know, like... I'm walking like my legs spread really wide. This is awful. Okay, we'll get back to you in a minute. I'll see you in North Carolina. Me. And actually, I just figured it out, and then I confirmed that they were all the way up there. So where I was, this is that tunnel that Johnny drives through right here. And when they hide from her parents, I mean, Dr. Houseman, this is the doorway he comes out of. And that is what I was looking for, because I knew that the building ended. But of course it starts again there, but there was like a They look from up there. And to get all the way up there, I don't want to do that again to match that shot. But thank goodness, I never give up. I never give up. It's too cold, I give up. So I am much further south now. I'm in North Carolina at Lake Lure. And these are where the locations of the famous steps are. There are some steps behind me, but I don't believe those are the correct ones. There's two stone steps. This is a gated private community. I got permission from somebody to come in here. I fell. We have some footage of that. Not fell, sunk, because it's dried up, but it's really muddy. And there is what you see. My hands were just now covered, completely covered in mud. And I washed it off in a nice North Carolina lake in February. But I'm trying to find those steps. Because you can't get a boat out here anymore. You used to be able to get a boat, but it's too, yeah. But you can't, there's no water. And you can't walk to it. So right there, you will see some stairs going up. And I'm almost 100% positive those are not the correct stairs. But it's filmed right in this little cove. And I believe the other stairs are over there. I'm going to try to get there a different way. If I can't, then I'm just going to put in a screenshot and still. But those stairs are very similar. This was absolutely brutal trying to get to this location. Because there's no way to get to it because it's private property. You can take boat tours, but this is the water. This is what we're looking at here.
This was much harder than I expected. Well, so, after much walking around, not only did I find the steps a lot easier than I thought it would, I ran into...
Wait a second, easier? Than you? That was pretty freaking difficult, man.
Was that one of your most difficult things you've ever
you
had to find?
You got stuck. I got stuck knee-high in mud.
Yeah.
You almost lost a shoe. I almost lost a shoe.
I thought I had to leave the shoe behind. Never, no man, no shoe left behind.
I know, you had to dig down in
I dig.
Up to here.
Look at my jacket. Oh, well.
You got it.
But we found the stairs. We have matched them up. They're right.
We didn't have to go over there.
We didn't have to do all that. They were on land the whole time. The lake, like I said, has dried up, eroded so much over the years that the White Bridge was taken out a long time ago. And the stairs go down onto land right here.
I think even before the water, you say eroded and the water on its own through Mother Nature made the lake dry up. I think developers dried the lake up.
Because of these new houses.
This is a newer house within the last probably 20 years.
Yeah.
But these are the stairs right here.
Right here. And this is the big reveal. There are the stairs. Now, we could get a little closer. I'm just going to zoom in.
Well, that's a private driveway.
The
public park area.
We're staying in the public park area of a gated community that we got permission to come on to. Just like to reiterate that it is gated. So...
But this is someone's private driveway.
This is someone's private driveway. So yeah, the bridge, the White Bridge in the movie would have come right out this way. And the water here, and as Adam said, developers would have dried up the lake. Let me zoom in.
How jagged the stairs are, though, which she's running up them or dancing up them. You can see how jagged each stair is.
Right. It looks exactly the same. And even on the right, if you look, see that first pole going up at the top of this, at the top? To the right, there's that rock still.
Yep.
And that rock is seen in the shot. That's the same rock. So these are definitely the stairs. I've just noticed that. I was looking for that rock and you can now see it. I'll zoom in a little closer. That rock is visible beside Jennifer Grey as she's dancing. Right there. This is as best as I can get in terms, I mean, I could literally walk and I could do the Jennifer Grey dance right now, which is what I wanted to do, to be honest, but I didn't realize there was a private driveway. I thought it went still out onto water. But those are the steps right there. They match perfectly. This was an ordeal. This is now the highlight of the video. The direction of Mike pointed right at Adam is very, very windy out here. Adam, you joined me in North Carolina. I was in Virginia for the first part. That was an ordeal. That was scary, but this is worth it almost.
I kind of had a little panic mode.
Oh yeah, me too.
You got stuck and I was like, take a deep breath, take it slow. It's not quicksand. You're not going to sink any farther, but your shoe was stuck. Then you got out and then I got excited to go back over to the other shore. And then I got stuck and you're like, oh, retribution. I'm going to watch you grovel in there.
But I didn't pull out the camera to film you. I was too worried.
I got out pretty quick, but it's pretty scary.
Yeah, because my shoe went, and then I was like, okay, this isn't so bad. But then I got up to here.
All the way up to your knee. Man.
Then up to the knee, and that's where I started thinking.
And you're slowly sinking.
Slowly. That's when I started thinking, I was like, I'm not going to die. I'm not going to die in this dry little lake bed. But then when it got to my knee, I was like, I could die.
Right. Well, you know. Eventually you would keep sinking it. 100%.
But how awesome, because now I can do this, da 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 da, and that's dirty dancing. Huh. Hey, you're dirty dancing now.
Dancing.
Hungry eyes.
She's like the wind.
Now, did you used to sing She Passes Wind as a kid? That's what we sang.
Never. How long did you know? How old were you when you realized it was Patrick Swayze singing that song?
I think around the same time. I was really into music, so.
I think I just blew some people's minds right now.
Yeah, yeah.
Patrick Swayze sings that song.
She's Like the Wind.
She's Like the Wind.
Yep. And it's at the, it's the second or third last song of the film.
Yeah.
Great.
It's a Swayze dog.
So far, we've had the time of our lives. Adam, will you be my baby? Oh, won't you stay? How many more can I do? Caught up in the excitement, this is where the staff quarters were. So where you saw me in Virginia walking up where their baby and Johnny are walking up and all those scenes, carrying the watermelons, all that, they switch to North Carolina here. And so I'm on the property of where the camp used to be. Now it's all torn down, it's all a new development. Just stopped at this little town on my way to the last location. And as Adam pointed out, there's these dirty dancing postcards, dirty dancing Lake Lure, and the watermelons. Because like I said, they cut from her and the watermelons over to the boys' camp. Well, it was a staff course, but it was a boys' camp back in the day. So that's how they did all that. So all the staff quarters were shot up here near Lake Lure. And those stairs, and there's something left that's pretty epic. I love you, Ferris Bueller. As well as you get the last location, look at Bigfoot. And look what he's doing. Look at her. Now, that actually, that looks like a Bigfoot, but that looks like a woman. Right?
What's that blowing her dress? Is that wind?
Well, yeah, she's like the wind.
She's like the wind.
That's exactly what it is. That's nice that they covered her up. But is that supposed to be Jennifer Grey, or is that supposed to be a female Bigfoot?
That's Jennifer Grey.
And Bigfoot's got her?
That's Swayze.
Swayze was hairy?
Later in life.
Hey, let's go do Harry and the Hendersons while we're here. I'm sure it's right here somewhere.
That's in Washington State.
Anybody know Harry and the Hendersons locations? Anyone? This town's dead. So, about a 10-minute drive from the steps is this building. This is the Esmeralda Inn. And inside, they have something from Dirty Dancing that is E-P-I-C. And for those of you who cannot spell, that spells awesome. So we're inside now, and look what's here.
Hello.
This floor that I'm walking on is the actual floor that Baby and Johnny danced on in the climactic scene. And not only is it the actual floor from that building, this is the actual section. They took the actual section. It was given this building and the one that I just showed you that burned down near the boys' camp. The boys' camp decided not to rebuild. They said, hey, do you want our floor? Because this one burned down at the same time, and they were rebuilding. They said, yeah, we'll take the floor, but we want the exact section. And this is the section.
Hey, baby.
This is incredible. They danced right here. Right here. And if I wasn't all muddy and dirty, I would be doing the dance. But I can barely walk. There it is. How cool is this, Adam?
It's pretty cool.
It's pretty cool. Now this is Lake Lure Inn and Spa. And inside, well, I'll explain where inside. I thought I was at the final location before, but no, I've got more. So we've made it to Lake Lure Inn. Lake Lure Inn is where the cast and crew stayed. And as you can see, this is a Patrick Swayze suite. During the filming of the motion picture Dirty Dancing, October 1986, Patrick Swayze resided here in the Lake Lure Inn. Now, the door's locked, we're not staying here. We just came here on a whim. How cool is that, Adam?
Pretty awesome.
Did you want to go inside?
I would like to get in there.
I would like to as well. Now, somebody just checked out of here, so housekeeping has not been in here yet. This is not the way the room, that place usually looks, but it's very small. So there's a couple of plates left of food, but people just checked out. But Patrick Swayze stayed in this room. Here we are. Now, I'm sure it's a different bed, but this is. Now, the rooms here are beautiful. Like I said, she wanted me to see the other rooms too, but we don't have time for that. This is Patrick Swayze's suite. Look at how big this is. Wow.
Oh.
Swayze living large.
Swayze dog in there.
Swayzemeister.
Yeah. That is awesome.
Did you ever think we'd get this far
this
in this video?
As close to Swayze as I've ever been.
Yeah. Like, some of this furniture has probably been here for a long time. It could be moved for another room. Who knows? But this is...
You know, Swayze probably looked out here.
Yeah. He probably sang She's Like the Wind looking out this window.
Maybe that's where he got the inspiration.
Yeah, it was really a windy day. He saw a young female walking by. Or that statue of the woman. And maybe it's made of styrofoam and it was Swayzing in the wind. Not only is that Patrick Swayze's suite, we're going to go show you Jennifer Grey's suite. Where she stayed. Now, I don't believe there's a plaque there. This is epic. This is crazy.
This is really cool.
Patrick Swayze stayed here. And then we're going to end it at one more location after Jennifer Grey's room. Oh my goodness. I think they do have a plaque. They do. The Jennifer Grey suite. Co-star to Patrick Swayze in the film Dirty Dancing, Jennifer Grey resided in the inn during the filming of the movie. Wow. Let's go in. Oh, it's nice. Ooh, very fresh. This is Jennifer Grey's suite. It's almost kind of the same, yeah. A little smaller.
I think I like this one better.
Really?
I like the setup of it better.
Yeah.
The kitchen's more open.
More light, for sure. There's more windows.
Yeah. That's amazing that they were staying here. Probably going over lines in here.
Yeah. 1422, 36 years ago, Jennifer Grey was in this room. Patrick Swayze was right below.
That is so cool. Wow.
Toaster oven, microwave.
Jennifer Grey was right over here.
Yeah.
Doing some dishes, washing some stuff.
Think she was doing dishes?
It's cool.
Just mentioning food gives me hungry eyes. Where's my drum roll? Now, one more iconic location is here that I did not know was here. And I'm going to show it to you now. Hey, there's twins on tricycles coming towards us.
Come and play with us,
guys. So right here, you're going to see a sign that says Johnny's Cabin. And up there, if I zoom in, right there, it says Baby's Bungalow. Now, again, I am in North Carolina, where I showed you Baby's family cabin. That is in Virginia. Johnny's Cabin was originally located where that boys' camp is. They just built these cabins in about around 2000, I was told, and they named them this. It's kind of a lake lure to get people to come here. The two towns kind of fight over Dirty Dancing history. If you want to check out online, it's very interesting. They both claim to be the site of the lake lift, where he lifts her up, and various scenes, but under much documentation, I can guarantee you the steps are here, but the lift scene was in Virginia.
You know what I'm noticing now? So you got this house here, you got this house here, and in the corner is Baby's.
Right.
In the corner.
And nobody puts Baby in. Now, we do have the key to Johnny's Cabin, but they didn't film anything inside. But this
was screen used inside here.
Inside. This used to be
mirror scenes.
All the mirror dance scenes. When they're practicing, during Hungry Eyes, the greatest song ever, after Chumbawamba. This is now a restaurant, but they filmed it in here.
Oh, there's people in there.
Oh.
That's why we couldn't go in.
Oh. I won't interrupt everyone. It is your hard of work here, but there it is. There's the piano. I'm sure that was not used in the movie. But
this is a cool piano.
Yeah, but it does have the same sort of look to it. But yeah, this is where they film those scenes. Thank you. I hope everything gets back to normal. Whatever you're working on.
Go visit the Flowering Bridge.
We did.
Okay.
We
this
did.
Is the board. Board of directors.
Oh, it's a beautiful town.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. There it is, right in there. All right, so I'm gonna end it here. Right inside there, that was where those mirror dancing was, which is one of my favorite scenes of the movie. Now, I believe I mentioned in Virginia about the log scene where they're dancing on a log. Nobody knows where, it was in the forest in Virginia, but nobody knows where that log is, so I can't find that log. Now, Adam, thank you. That was awesome, we met up here.
I was only here for the North Carolina.
Mm-hmm.
Scenes.
But the best part was those steps.
I got muddy, my feet are dirty, did a little dancing.
We did do a little dancing. And today is Valentine's Day.
As of recording of this.
As of the recording of this. Adam likes to document each day, but we're actually here on Valentine's Day. So I think, are we going for dinner?
You buying?
I'm buying.
Steaks all around.
Hungry eyes.
She's hungry. Right. Come on. I eat green berets for breakfast.
Was Arnold in it? Arnold was in Dirty Dancing?
And right now, I'm very hungry for my eyes.
I'm from my eyes. I can't do it. I can do Jerry. I want to give a big special shout out before I forget to LBC Rec 562. That's my boy Danny in California. I'm going to put a link to his channel below. I want everyone to subscribe to that. All About Los Angeles. He's just started a YouTube channel. He has an Instagram. Sean, he helps me out so much. And my good friend Ryan for going to the movies, who shot Last of Mohegan out here. Those two guys have helped me a lot so much on the channel. So I want to take the opportunity right now before I forget. I'm going to put a link below to their channels because those three guys are awesome. And Adam, you've helped me so much too. Boom! I'm taking the woo to dinner. Lobster on me! Don't eat off of me.
That's just creepy.
No, I'm very clean. Peace! Well, no, actually, after the mud, I'm very dirty. How appropriate. It's Dirty Dancing. Hey, baby. Peace out.